I would say it was not that difficult to dissent in while being in government. But there are questions like when you are taking the decision, you can actually take the decision to say, whatever be the consequences, I'll not take this decision. The maximum consequence is what? As an IAS officer, any of those All India service, you have something called a bulletproof vest. You know, that is Article 311. So they can't dismiss you or anything. You have a protection. But even if you are wearing a bulletproof vest, it takes a hell lot of courage to stand up and take that bullet. You know nothing will happen, but still you have to take that bullet. So it's not that taking those decisions while being in the service is not that difficult. You can say that no. You may transfer. There is one minister, I remember, he called me up and he said, Kannan, this is not acceptable. You are interfering in things which, I said, sir, it's okay, you can transfer me. So immediately his response was, this was in one place, so immediately response was, I want to, but there are not enough competent people. So at least that is a good politician. He understood that, okay, you want to be somebody else to be there. But matter of, like what happened in Kashmir. Okay. Now what happened in Kashmir was not with my consent. The file did not go through with my opinion. It happened, when the government decided, the moment it decided that an entire population can be shut down for whatever decision it wants to enforce, the entire population, today it is 117th day if I am not wrong, 117 days. And till now, many of the elected leaders, the ex-chief ministers, lot of political, they are all under jail, either jail or house arrest or something. People have been locked down in hotels and said you can't get out. People, the mobile phone and the internet connectivity is still not, 4 months. Imagine it's still 4 months and so any decision government is taking, and thing is not what the government did. At that point of time, what I realized is that after that, the rest of the country decided to keep quiet. The media decided to keep quiet. The judiciary, the media, in fact the PCA gave an affidavit in the Supreme Court saying we don't have any objection to what the government is saying, putting the restrictions. The judiciary said, habeas corpus petition, IAS officer, one of the things, Shah Faisal was arrested and then taken to Srinagar. So the kind of events that succeeded or happened after this application of 370, that made me realize that it's not the government, it's the people who have given up on this country. The people have decided that maybe the mandate of 350 or something was too much for people to understand or digest. So they just decided whatever they do is what the people of this country wants, and hence we should keep quiet. Now just want to talk about that mandate a little bit. It's a 40% mandate of whoever voted. 65% voted. So you multiply 40 into 65. It comes to around 27%, 28%. It's a 28% mandate of total eligible voters. There is still a 72% population which is not agreed to whatever is happening. But if you look at any of the discourse, any discourse in social media, any of the places, you would think that 90% of the country agrees with whatever is happening. Because they are the ones who are speaking, the 72% decided to keep quiet. And that is what, that silence was so deafening, that just keeping quiet part. Anything can happen in Kashmir. And we were having memes of how to marry a Kashmiri girl, how to purchase land there, those are the kind of things, discourse that this country did at that point of time, to our own people, to our own citizens. When that happened, then I realized that, somebody was asking what is the trigger. There's no trigger. It was like a frog in the boiling water. I was telling, it's getting warm, 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 warm. And if the frog does not jump, usually the frogs don't jump. It just stays there until it gets boiled. If you heat it slowly enough, don't try it, but if you heat it slowly enough, it does not jump. It just stays there, and it really boils. And that's what was happening. It was slowly getting warmer, hotter and this thing, and I decided somebody had to jump out and say the water is getting hot. It's getting warm and it's getting more and more, and that somebody is heating it. It's not just it is getting hot, somebody is heating it also. Somebody had to tell that. So, and since nobody outside decided to say that, I thought maybe it's okay, just one job. So, I'll find some other job. Being in the system, you can take decisions saying no to, they'll come after you, they'll come after a lot of things, there'll be a lot of issues. But still there are people who are doing it. But when you slightly broaden the moral compass to things which you can't influence directly by being in the system and which you know is wrong, and you want to be in a position to at least influence the opinion making about that, then it's difficult. Then you have to get out. So in fact, I got charge sheeted for talking about Kashmir. I got charge sheeted after my submitting my resignation. 3 months after my resignation letter, I got charge sheeted saying that if I, by talking to media on Kashmir, I have created an adverse image on the government. And one of the things was also that maybe country's foreign relations is affected. I replied on Twitter saying that it is not my interaction but your action which is causing all this. So anyway, sir might be able to answer.
No, I just wanted to think more to add to what Kannan said. Just to answer your question very directly, inside government we can talk to our higher ups through files, or we can talk to our minister through files. So there are many things that they have written in files, we have said no. And it goes to him only, it stays there. What we cannot do inside in government is like talk against it. Talk against its policies, ridicule its policies in public. Because they are very, you know, as a government they are very afraid, you know, because I am in the internal close where I know many things and they don't want me to tell anything. This has been the case. So to be very frank, that we cannot do. But there are so many officers, so many, you know, instances where many policies of the government has been rejected, and there are also many instances where spinelessly we have agreed. My hatred towards the current dispensation started in 2002 when Gujarat happened, and you know, and my respect for certain people stayed there only, you know, it didn't grow much beyond that. And to my own brethren, that civil servants who were supposed to put their foot and say a no and come up in arms saying that, you know, this constitution doesn't allow us, our conscience doesn't allow us, didn't do it. And we collectively should take the blame for that. So I think, you know, that since that is in my mind, it's always there that, you know, one has to come out. If not in government, okay, we come out and do. The life is very big, there will be so many things to do.